If you have low voltage under cabinet or under counter lights, chances are a normal wall mounted dimmer won't work. You'll get flickering, flashing, or nothing at all. If your lights have a transformer or non-Romex wires running to them, there's a good chance they're low voltage. Check with your electric supply warehouse or go to the transformer manufacturer's website and call tech support for a compatible dimmer. If you can buy something at Home Depot, the company will probably have a robust tech support department. There's an easy fix, albeit not a cheap one. We're installing a Lutron Diva dimmer. There's an affiliate link in the description. This video is meant to show that low voltage lights can be dimmed at a wall switch. It's not an electrical tutorial. We'll share a link to a more in-depth video. If you can install a light switch, you can probably handle this. If you're not confident or capable, there's no shame in calling someone who is. What's up guys, we're doing a quick video. We just finished our all-electric tap room. There are LED under-counter lights that we want to put on a dimmer. They're too bright. This is a Lutron, we got it from the electric supply house. Terry, how much did it cost?
$120.
$120, so when you're putting in under-counter lights that are low voltage, factor this into your price. We have the power off. We'll test with a non-contact voltage meter. We're gonna put this one in now. Terry's gonna show you how it's done. So these aren't like normal dimmers. They have wires that need to be done in a certain sequence. Polarity does matter with these low voltage dimmers. This one needs to be wired to the load side, for example, and this neutral needs to be tied in. So there was a short at some point. We're gonna cut that out. Shorts like this are unfortunately too common. That's why we tape all of the exposed brass and screws. Little hook on the strippers is usually.
What a throwback!
I told you I don't listen to a lot of new shit.
For making a hook. You want to make sure you set the hook so as you tighten it, it's not loosening up the wire connection. There we go. So this one is labeled, which is nice. We can verify that with a voltage meter. So the terms are line and load. Feed in this case is the line going in. So this wire is going out to the fixture. Neutral pigtails. Neutrals are all spliced together. This requires a neutral. So this is right set up.
She was gonna pay like $20,000.
Now that we're done, time to verify and read the instructions. Circuit off. That's in Spanish. All right, so before we put everything back together, we're gonna test this, make sure it's working okay. Then we're gonna tape the exposed sides and tape all of our connections here and then tuck everything in, make sure it's neat.
Good. This one doesn't have any exposed connections on the outside, so we're not gonna wrap that one. But you can see right here where those wires are going into this switch, they're exposed. And so what we're gonna do is wrap the whole box right here in electrical tape. A lot of people will consider it a waste of time. And as we pointed out earlier, the short that we had, that was from these not being taped.
These tabs oftentimes need to come off on one side, they snap off. Make sure to take these and throw them down your garbage disposal. Give the plumber a headache. Don't do that.
Now that we've got everything back in place and the switches screwed in place, we're gonna go ahead and put our cover on faceplate and make sure that fits and everything lines up nicely. And we're gonna go ahead and call that good, and we're gonna screw these screws back in. I'm a fan of the vertical screws.